Hi, welcome back to LiveBinders, your online digital binder platform. In this video, we'll do a quick overview of tabs in a LiveBinder. Today, we are utilizing Alabama's Department of Education's Digital Learning Repository, and they have done a fantastic job with designing their LiveBinder. On the left side, you can see the tabs. Now, these are the first level of tabs, and within tabs, you can add subtabs. Now, subtabs are a second level of tabs, and they have color-coded their subtabs yellow. And if you have a subscription on your LiveBinders account, you can add base tabs. And base tabs are a third level of tabs, and their base tabs are gray. Now, in each level of tabs, you can have uploaded files, embedded multimedia like YouTube videos, pictures, or apps, or you can also link websites directly into your tab. Now, let's go back to the table of contents. And the table of contents will be automatically populated with the tab titles and will be linked to the tabs. Now, here you can see you have your main tabs, your subtabs, and you can also see what subtabs have base tabs. And like I said, they are linked. So if you click on a tab here, it will go directly to that tab. So we clicked on the subtab and we're back in a subtab. Now, if you don't like the location of the tabs, you can change them to a different location. Click on the options button, select layout, and select the location you would like to display your tabs. You can have them on the right side instead of the left, or if you would like, you can also add them or display them to the top of the screen as a stack tab. And that is our quick review on tabs. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up below. For more tips and tricks to use on your LiveBinder, subscribe to our channel or visit us at livebinders.com. Thank you.